So I get asked this question from streamers looking to upgrade their PC all the time. Can this PC handle both playing and streaming a game at the same time? Whether you're new to streaming or a seasoned pro, the requirements for PC hardware are always changing, and I figured it was time to update this video that I did. I made one almost 2 years ago, and I wanted to give you guys an update. If you're considering a new build or thinking about upgrading your current setup, we're gonna talk about the differences between streaming your console, a dual PC setup, and even have a couple of recommendations for that single PC setup in just a second. But first, pull up a stool and let's raise a glass to KCGameOn for making this video possible. KCGameOn hosts LAN parties, gaming events, charity streams, and the Kansas City Corporate Esports Cup right here in Kansas City. If you're looking to play with other local gamers in KC, make sure you join their Discord server, which I'll link down in the description. And if you need a sick new gaming PC to show off at an event, definitely let me know. Cheers. Now, I recommend a lot of CPU and GPU combos, as well as build a bunch of streaming PCs. But how do we know what specs are going to work for playing and streaming the game at the same time? After tons of research, I kind of came to the conclusion that there's no real formula out there that I could find to figure this out. So I ended up just making my own. It's pretty easy. Really, what you want to do is look at the games that you're going to be playing. Is it all over the board or is it one specific game? If it's one specific game or if it's a lot of different games, take the game that has the highest system requirements. Go to their websites, do a Google search. It's easy enough to find. Find the game's recommended specs. After that, I add one tier higher up to the CPU requirement. So if it requires an i3 processor, I look at the i5 processor. If it requires an i5, I look at the i7 version. Then all of this is going to be over and inclusive of your budget. Now we're gonna get into a couple of specific recommendations, but first let's figure out what some of these parameters are that we're actually working with. We need to figure out what your goals are for streaming. Are you doing this just for the fun of it? Do you want to play your favorite games on stream no matter what it is? Do you want to become a professional variety streamer? Figuring out your end goal is going to help us figure out how much time and money that you want to invest and what type of setup you're going to want to look into and what parts you may need in a PC. I asked my social media in a couple different polls, how do you stream? And the vast majority of people ended up saying they use a single PC setup. It's definitely going to be the simplest of all of these, but each setup has their own pros and cons. Now, if you're the type of person that only wants to stream a single game or just wants to have fun with their friends, plugging your console into a computer has never been easier to be able to get that streaming going. This is probably one of the most budget-friendly options, just because I assume at this point you already have a console, and chances are you already have a computer that's capable of doing the streaming. All you probably need to buy is a decent capture card, like one of the Elgato cards. I'll definitely have those linked down below as well. The beauty of this setup is that your PC doesn't need to be a beast. Something with an Intel i5, much older generation, a 9th, 10th generation, something like a Ryzen 5 3600 will do just fine. This is going to be perfect for beginners or anyone who doesn't want to invest heavily in a gaming PC right away to get started with a streaming career to test it out and see if it's right for you. Next, we're gonna move to the most common setup, streaming and gaming on the same PC at the same time. This is where you're gonna need to start thinking about a little bit more of a balanced build. For 2024, I recommend at least an i7-12700K or an AMD Ryzen 7 7700X paired with a GPU like the 3060 Ti or the RX 6700 XT. Now, this obviously is very dependent on the games that you want to play, the quality that you want to play them in, the quality that you want your stream to be in, all of those different things, as well as what other applications you want open at the same time. All of these things play a huge part in the setup that you need for your stream. This setup is going to be great for most streamers who want to play the latest games and stream them without hiccups. Finally, we have the pro level option, a dual PC setup. Now, this is the go-to for serious streamers who want to play at the absolute highest settings without sacrificing any quality anywhere. Your gaming rig can be maxed out with something like the Ryzen 7 7800X3D or an i9-12900K or one of the newer Intel processors if you trust the microcode they just released. And something like an RTX 4070 Ti Super 4080 or an RX 7900 XTX. While your streaming PC can be a little bit more modest, you know, a Ryzen 5 5600 with a GTX 1660 Super, something along those lines would be more than enough for that computer. This setup is gonna offer the best performance, but does come with some additional costs and definitely some complexities. All right, so since most of you all want to set up a single streaming and gaming PC setup, it is the most common, probably the simplest when it comes to setup. That's what we're going to really dive into here. I'm gonna give you what I think is right now the best bang for your buck machine to be able to game, stream, create content, edit videos, all of that on one single machine. Let's take a look at some of the key components of this machine. So the CPU is the heart and brain of your system. For a single PC setup, I can't stress enough how important it is to go with something a little bit higher end, like the Intel i7-12700K or a Ryzen 7 7700X or something even bigger, depending on exactly what you want to do and the quality that you want to run it at. This should be more than enough to play and stream most games, 1080p. These CPUs though are going to offer the core counts and the clock speeds that are needed to handle both gaming and streaming workloads at the same time. If you're looking to future-proof your build, something like the i9-12900K, or if you trust some of the newer Intel processors, or the Ryzen 9 7950X are some top-tier options. As far as the GPU, this is equally critical, especially if you're gaming at higher resolutions. The 3060 Ti, the RX 6700 XT are about the minimum that I would go for people that are looking to be variety streamers. If you're looking to stream whatever the new and hot game is that comes out and you're looking to play it at some decent settings while still streaming it, I would recommend this as an absolute baseline, but really if you want to play at some decent settings, I would probably find something a little bit newer, something a little bit more powerful, something with a little bit more VRAM. Now, if you're streaming solely esports titles, think Fortnite, Counter-Strike, Valorant, Rocket League, those types of games, you could probably get away with something a little bit less, but again, for the price and the cost of some of these cards, I think those might be some of the best options for just about everybody at this point. If you're looking to push things a little bit farther, like I recommended before, maybe a 4070, maybe an RX 7800 XT, these cards are gonna be great, and especially the NVIDIA cards. Having that latest NVENC encoder is going to offload a lot of those streaming tasks from your CPU, making your streams run even smoother. Now, in terms of memory, 16 gigabytes was the standard a couple of years ago, but with more demanding games coming out and the multitasking nature of streaming, I really believe that 32 gigabytes is the new sweet spot. This is going to ensure that you won't run into any bottlenecks, especially when you've got multiple applications open, Discord, Spotify, OBS, I'm looking at you. All right, and then storage is another area where you don't want to skimp. Modern games are massive, often going more than 100 gigabytes. I recommend at least a terabyte NVMe solid state drive for your OS and your games, which will drastically reduce the load times and make your system feel snappier overall. If you are recording VODs and doing some video editing, I would definitely consider either upgrading that to 2, maybe even 4 terabytes, or getting some really fast external hard drives or extra drives that you can save all of those videos on. There's nothing worse than running out of hard drive storage and having to uninstall a game to install the next one. If you have a little bit different of a budget, want to run some of your games at higher or lower settings? There are so many options on the market right now. And I've actually got four specific CPU and GPU combos in this video right here, as well as a couple alternative options in each price range. You'll definitely want to check that one out. We'll see you over there.